Welcome back to the channel, guys, and welcome back to the fifth and last installment of this whip, the 1956 Ford Fairlane Victoria is ready, completely built, and I'm going to show you guys the end result. Let's try to make my little tripod here to work a little better. Put the car in focus. Here we have it. A 1956 Ford Fairlane Victoria, ready, completely ready. The paint was done in synthetic enamel, it's automotive paint, and now it was waxed by the last time, last and final time, with Meguiar's Tech Wax 2.0 to get this shine. Paint was airbrushed with my Badger 350 single action airbrush. The interior is a slightly different tone of red. I just love the chrome on this kit. Those re-releases by Round 2 have a great, great chrome, and I love it. This build is completely box stock. I only added decals and the carpeting that was done with velour paper. The most boring work done to the car, to this car, and to this kit is the foiling of the interior, most precisely the interior side panels on the rear. Those are a pain in the ass to foil. And the rest of the kit is a breeze to foil. The kit goes together like a dream. Even though the tooling is really, really old, I see no problems building it. Just a little bit of flash to sand. I did my best to replicate what the Ford factory would do with this car back in 1956. I did the color separation between the black and the red on the factory spots, where what is red is supposed to be red, what is black is supposed to be black. I try to keep things the most authentic as I can. The carpeting is something a little subtle. It's something that's hard to notice, and I kind of like that. All the badges on the body were foiled prior to painting. And then the paint was removed from the badges with a little lacquer thinner and a toothpick. Something that's a little fiddly to do, but produces great results. Let's see if I can show you guys in more detail here the interior of the car. I hope I can. Hope you can see the carpeting there. That was present in the whip. I added some custom decals. Like you guys know, this one, for example, is the lifeguard design decal. as a 56, the 56 Ford was kind of a car where Ford was trying to promote safety. So it was the beginning of the lifeguard design. Also, those little squares here are a decal that I showed you guys on a previous video. The license plates are also custom decals. They are the brand new license plates we are starting to use here in Brazil, and they represent the Mercosul license plates, as in South America, common market, and the cars from many countries, including Brazil, Argentina, Uruguay, will use the very same license plates, and this is the Brazilian version. It has the car has the parts pack tires with painted wide white walls. The white walls from the tires, the temple printed white walls are on the inside of the tires. Hope you guys can see. I thought they would look kind of cool on the inside, and the painted white walls on the outside. Let's try to make the camera to focus a little better. So here we have them. The painted white walls that have the Firestone name and the gum dipped right there. We also have the custom-made decal for the Ford Crest on the tires, on the center of the wheel covers. Here on the back, on the Fairlane name, it's not a decal, it's just a little black wash that actually leaves the Fairlane name showing off. So quite nice. This time I was able to avoid any kind of touch up on the paint, what's always good, as when you touch up paint to make it blend with the rest, there is always the risk of your ending sending paint through and right to the primer and having to redo things. Now, through the camera, I'm seeing that I have a little walks on the grooves of the side trim. Funny, I couldn't see that without the camera. Now let's close the doors, shall we? Doors closed. They close quite nice, not perfect, but quite nice. I did a lot of dry fitting with the doors, but that always changes a bit with the thickness of the paint. So even though the door closing is not quite perfect, like kind of here, I'm quite satisfied with what I have. I can't ask for more. show you guys the underside of this beast. So here you have the chassis with all the parts built and mounted. The underside of the Ford 312 V8. Dual exhaust. All the running gear is rear, is here. The kit kind of lacks the rear bumper brackets, and I didn't add any. Let's see if I can open the engine. So here we have the 312 cubic inch Y-block V8. It's kind of nice. The master cylinder is a resin copy of a master cylinder I had in my parts box. The C-Clear bag is a decal. And I think the car just really looks apart with the hood and the doors open. Don't you guys think? I think so. It's a great looking automobile, the 56 Ford Fairlane Victoria. And the Fiesta Red and Raven Black also help a lot with the looks of the car. As you all guys know, my camera is not exactly the best for the filming, but it is quite good for taking pictures. So I'll put now a little slideshow of pictures of the model, outdoor and indoors, so you guys can see things in more detail. And like always, please feel free to comment and ask questions. And well, you guys know the drill, right? I'm quite happy with this model. Quite happy it is finally done. It took me quite a while. I'm really not used to take more than a couple of weeks on a car, and this one took me a little over a month. So well guys, thank you for watching the video. Have a nice weekend. And please stay tuned for the slideshow. Bye bye.
Forever, my darling, my love will be true, always and forever. Just promise me, darling, your love in return. Make this fire in my soul, dear, forever burn. My heart's at your command, dear, to keep love and to hold. Making you happy is my desire, dear. Keeping you is my goal. I'll forever love you the rest of my days. I'll never part from you and your loving way. love and to hold. Making you happy is my desire, dear. Keeping you is my goal. I'll forever love you the rest of my days. I'll never part from you and your love.